Welcome back, gang. So we are going to start a brand new series. It's going to be a short series, but it was inspired by a comment from the social network series that I did. And basically, someone wanted me to extract the friendship system from the social network series and change it into an API instead of using inertia to sort of eager load all the information that we needed. So they specifically asked for React, but to be honest, I don't know React well enough to put together a project and then show you how to do it. It just, nobody would benefit from that because there will, chances are, be a lot of mistakes and errors, and I don't want to do that to you. Okay, so what I did was instead, I put this little app together, and the way it's designed, Laravel is going to be on the back end. It's going to control the API. It's also going to control our authentication using Fortify. And then on the front end, it's going to be using Nuxt.js. And the way that we're going to set it up, you can easily change out that front end for anything you want, but still continue to use the API and the authentication from Laravel. Okay, so as I said, we're just going to be using Laravel Fortify to handle the back end, the authentication for us, because I really do like this package. Okay, and we're going to be connecting the two apps, the Laravel and the Nuxt, through Laravel Sanctum. All right, it's going to be really cool. We're going to be using Nuxt.js, so we're going to have an install of Nuxt, which is fine. And then we're also going to have this package back here that basically allows us to use Laravel Sanctum with Nuxt without a problem. It's its own provider. Okay, so let me just show you really quick what this is going to look like. We're able to register a user. Okay, like I said, we're going to be using Fortify to handle all this, so all of this works. The only thing I added was the username to it, but everything else is the same. But we're going to use the login for right now, just for the demonstration. Okay, so I have a user already in there, and we just add in the password and we log right into the app. I don't have anything for this dashboard page, but I just wanted to have some sort of landing page that's only accessible to authenticated users once you log in. So it just says dashboard here, and you can see the link up here, the URL. Okay, so what we have here is a list of users. Okay, these are all the users I just seeded into the database. And if you go to one, let's say this one, okay, once this loads up, this is a user that we can add as a friend. Okay, so then we'll click add, and then as you can see, it says pending. Now we can also go to the friends tab right here, and you'll see this is a list of all the users that have sent us friend requests, and this is our friend that we do have. Okay, so let's just pick one of the friend requests. Okay, we also have an accept and ignore. Can accept that. And now we can we have a new friend. So the button is now changed to unfriend. So if we go back to our friends, we now have two users. Okay, and then also you can ignore the request. So if you click that user, okay, we'll now click ignore, and this will remove the friend request. Okay, and now we can go back and add. So as I said, it's super simple. I didn't add any loaders or anything, any events or anything like that. I just wanted to demonstrate how you would do this particular system with an API. In the next episode, we are going to start our project setup, and we're going to pull in these packages that we need to get this working. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.